Recently, Anzer launched a 130-watt GaN charger. Unlike most multi-port high-power chargers, all those four output ports are USB-C, and it didn't have any USB-A ports. It reduces the charger compatibility somewhat, but you can say goodbye to the old USB-A port. Let's tear off the plastic film and introduce this charger to you. The front of the box is printed with Anzer and 130W GaN fast charge. Here is the charger. The compatible devices are printed on the side. All the features and specs info are on the back. We'll talk about it later. Take it out. Except for the charger itself, it also comes with a powered extension cord. First, let's take a look at the charger. It adopts black matte plastic with Anzer in the center. All the specs info are printed on the side. Model is AZ1130. It supports input of 120V, 50 or 60Hz, 2A. And the USB-C 1C2 can go up to 50W output, while the USB-C 3C4 can go up to 100W output. If you charge 4 devices at the same time, the power will be divided into 20W, 20W, 30W, and 60W. 130 watts in total. The input ports can be folded. All 4 USB-C ports are on the opposite side, with an indicator light on the button. Then let's take a look at the power extension cord. Its length is about 1.5 meters. The plug has a U-shaped slot and 2 clips on both sides to fix it. You can flip the clip at the top to remove it from the charger. Slide the plug into the input end. It turns into a charging station and can be placed on your desktop. The size of the charger is about 74x74x32mm. Compared with the Apple 140W charger, this size is slightly smaller, but it can charge up to 4 devices at once. The weight of the charger is about 239 grams. The Chitlet Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C one supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A protocols, and QC3.0, QC5, AFC, SCP, PD3.0, PPS fast charging protocols. And it also has 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 2.5A, and a set of PPS. The USB-C 2 can support the same protocols as the USB-C 1, and the PDL info is also the same. Then the KM002C shows the USB-C 3 supports QC3.0, QC5, AFC, FCP, SCP, PD3.0, and PPS fast charging protocols. It also has 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols and PDL info of the USB-C 4 are the same as the USB-C 3. The USB-C 1 port of most multi-port chargers can output the peak power, but this charger is the opposite, so please check it carefully before using it. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart to see how it can support 4 USB-C ports at the same time. Start from the bottom cover. Use the spudger to pry along the gap and remove it. Then the internal module can be easily taken out. The entire module is wrapped with brass heatsink for heat dissipation. Cut off the red and black wires and disconnect them from input prongs. Then remove the brass heatsink on the front and back side. We found the internal components are filled with silicone adhesives for heat dissipation and fixing. 2 black mylar sheets are inserted into the PCB slot to insulate the primary and secondary sides. Chitlet found this charger has the BFC circuit, and the LLC topology of the switching power supply can output a fixed voltage. Then the fixed voltage will be rectified by the synchronous rectification circuit. The time delay fuse is from Better Electronics, 5A, 250 volts. The green common mode choke can suppress the EMI interference. The X2 safety capacitor is 0.47 microfarad. And the second common mode choke is larger than the first one and is wrapped with tape for insulation. 2 bridge rectifiers are soldered on a small vertical PCB. They are connected in parallel to form the half bridge circuit and can share the heat evenly. The output filter inductor is under the second Kumamo choke, and the red film capacitor is from TQ cap, 1 microfarad, 450 volts. This is the 2-in-1 primary controller from MBS HR1211, which integrates multi-mode PFC controller and current mode LLC controller. It integrates bootstrap diode and the specs info can be configurable. This scan IC is from Navitas and is used for PFC boost. It adopts QFN 6x8 package and the heat dissipation performance has been improved. 650 volts, 125 milliohm. Those two current sampling resistors are connected in parallel and are used to detect the current of the PFC boost GaN IC. The resistance is 100 milliohm. The PFC boost inductor is tightly wrapped with tape for insulation. The PFC boost rectifier is from Global Power and adopts DFN 5x6 package. And the maximum operating temperature is 175 degrees Celsius, 650 volts, 4 amp. The electrolytic capacitor for high voltage filtering is from CHN cap, 82 microfarad, 450 volts. And the solid capacitor that powers the primary controller is also from CHN cap, 35 volts, 100 microfarad. Those two LLC MOSFETs are from London and adopts PDFN 8x8 package. They can form the half-bridge circuit, 700 volts, 180 milliohm. The resonant capacitor is 0.022 microfarad, 630 volts. And here is the LLC resonant inductor. And then the LLC transformer is tightly wound with tape. The low voltage side is connected to the synchronous rectification PCB through two black wires. The white optocoupler is used for output voltage feedback. The SMD white capacitor is from TRX. The LLC synchronous rectifier controller is from MPS. It integrates two controllers, which are used for synchronous rectification of two secondary coils, respectively. Those two synchronous rectifiers are from Hontech and adopts a DFN 5x6 package, 65 volts, 3.8 milliohm. Those two solid capacitors are connected in parallel and also from CHN cap, 25 volts, 680 microfarad. There are four secondary buck PCBs corresponding to four USB-C outputs. Since the maximum output power is 50 watts and 100 watts, so there are two types of output PCB. This is the 100 watts output PCB. The protocol chip is from iSmartware, used for step-down control and protocol identification. And two buck MOSFETs are from ReChips and adopts PDFN 3333 package. 40 volts, 5.5 milliohm. The solid capacitor for output filtering is also from CHN cap, 25 volts, 220 microfarad. Then this is the 50 watts output PCB. The protocol chip is also from iSmartware, but in a different model. It integrates a 3.5 amp synchronous rectification buck converter and supports various charging protocols. This solid capacitor is the same as the one on the 100 watts output PCB. The USB-C connector is from KRCON. Finally, the 32-bit MCU with M0 core is from ChipC, which is responsible for the automatic power distribution of each USB-C port. Its maximum operating frequency is 24 MHz and it adopts QFN 20 package. Well, that's all components of this ANZER 130 watts GaN charger with 4 USB-C ports. After taking apart, we found it adopts LLC topology and integrates 4 independent output PCBs to support 4 USB-C ports. If you're really fed up with the old USB-A ports and want to move into a new era of USB-C, you might consider this charger, but make sure all your devices support USB-C. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you in the next video. Bye!